Verse 26 says, then said Elikam, the son of Elikam, speak. He said, no, let me just speak in English. He says to these guys, to the heathens, to Rapskana, he says, listen, guys, hey, you're shouting here on the fence on the wall. I can understand your language. Don't speak to us in Hebrew. Speak to us in Syrian. You know, we don't want everybody else just listening and getting upset and panicking. Just speak directly to me, to us. In your language, we understand you very clearly. The rest of the people around, they don't need to hear what's going on. Ah, this guy, Rebecca says, do you think I came here to speak to you? Do you think I just came to speak to Hezekiah? My friend, I'm speaking to all of you, every single one of you. Well, from Jerusalem, you Judas or whatever you, I'm speaking to everyone. You must hear me in your language so that you cannot say you couldn't understand. I'm speaking. This guy is arrogant. And he's, well, let's see. You know, when you come backed up with 10,000, 20,000, 50,000, 100,000 men behind you, and they all got arms and everything else, and the people you're going up are maybe 10,000, you know, you can get arrogant. Sister Chiwani Mere, it's good to see you in the house today. May God be praised. So there, they come up and these guys are getting more and more arrogant because it's just obvious that they're going to take on Hezekiah. It's just common sense to them. Common sense and God are two different things. Common sense to you and I and man are one thing. But common sense, God confuses the sense of man with things that we would call nonsense. When God comes, he just has to send one guy in the middle of the night, and the whole 100,000 people are taken out. That's the God we serve. Amen. Are you still there? Right, coming back to the story. So there, Elikai, the son of Elikai, speaks there. And Rabshah says, I'm speaking to all of you. Now listen to what he says in verse 27. Please give me permission, because this is from the word of God. But Rabshah said unto them, hath my master sent me to thy master, and to thee, to speak these words? Hath he not sent me to the men which sit on the wall, and they that eat their own dung and drink their own piss with you? Can you imagine? This guy is blasphemous. He is filthy. But then Rabshakeh, I mean, if you've got a name like Rabshakeh, you are shaky. It's already telling you, he's confused. Stood and cried with a loud voice in the Jews' language, and spake, hear the word of the great Assyrian king. Let not Hezekiah deceive you. He shall not be able to deliver you out of my hand. I am coming. I'm telling you again, your cities, everything shall not stand. They will be delivered into the hand of the king of Assyria. Verse 31, hearken not to Hezekiah, I'm telling you. For thus saith the king of Assyria, make an agreement with me and a present and come to me. And then he says, listen to this line. And then eat of every man of his own vine, and every one of his own fig tree, and drink you every one of the waters of the cistern, until I come and take you away to a land like your own land, a land of corn and wine, bread and vineyards, a land of olive oil and honey, that he may and may not die, that he may live and not die. And hearken not unto Hezekiah, which he persuaded you, saying, the Lord will deliver us. This guy's a liar. He took the Samaritans and he took them to a desert land on the side of a river, on the side of the ocean somewhere, and just dumped them there. Not a land of milk and honey. And now he comes and he's telling these guys, listen, like they don't know what he's doing. Information travels fast. Today we've got cell phones and everything else, yes. But those days they had faster information. I don't know what he was called, but he was fast. And they already knew what was going on. And this guy just carried on. And listen to what he says in verse 34. He says, where are the gods of Hamath and of Arphad? Where are the gods of Sephron, Hena, and Eva? Have they delivered Samaria out of my hand? Who are they among all the gods of the countries that have delivered their country out of mine hand? That the Lord should deliver Jerusalem out of thine hand. But the people held their peace and answered him not a word. And for the king's command was, saying, answer him not. This guy was serious. These guys were, well, they had a reason to be. Let's go to chapter 19. What does Hezekiah do when he starts getting this information? The first one, Here is the answer to the first answer to the situation you find yourself in. When trouble, what do you do when trouble troubles you? What do? Listen to what he does. And it came to pass, when King Hezekiah heard it, that he rent his clothes and covered himself with sackcloth, and went and spoke to his generals, and spoke to all the mighty men of Israel, all the mighty men of Judah, and he spoke to all these soothsayers and finances and everybody. He called them all together. Is that what Hezekiah did? Huh? Because that's the common sense thing to do. You go speak to your army generals. You go speak to the guys with the money. You go speak to everybody. Can we afford to go up against this guy? We've got enough ammunition, guns, bullets, and all that. That's what you do. But what does he do? And Hezekiah covered himself with sackcloth and went into the house of the Lord.
Amen.
Are you listening?
Amen.
This is the key. He's always been the key. Turn with me. Just hold it there. Turn with me to Colossians. Colossians chapter 1. Colossians is in the New Testament, by the way. Colossians chapter 1 and verse 16. Colossians 1 verse 16, the Bible says, for by him, that's Jesus Christ, for by Jesus were all things created, that is in the heaven and that are in earth, visible and invisible. Whether they be thrones or dominions or principalities or powers, all things were created by him and for him. And verse 17, and he is before all things, and by him all things consist. Are you listening this morning? The key to every situation is Jesus Christ.
Amen.
The key to every problem that you have is Jesus Christ.
Amen.
The key to every solution that you have is Jesus Christ. Nobody else can do this. Because why? Because he says, I am the author. I have created. Listen, he says, and the Bible is clear to say that even principalities and powers, darkness in high places, Jesus is in control. No one, Sister White says, no one can touch you unless you allow him. Are you listening? The demons cannot touch you unless you start now going to nyangas and soothsayers and all these things. Then they can. They not only touch you, they will bite you.
Amen.